Welcome everyone, this is Sean Thomas and we're looking at the patch notes for the upcoming patch 228. It's estimated for being December 21st, 2015. I'm going to speculate that this will likely not take place on the 21st and will likely follow in the next couple days. Likely sometime before December 25th, that would be my guess, but probably not for another day or two. Alright, so taking a look at what we've got coming up, we've got the ARK Winter Wonderland. I think that'll be the primary visual or felt experience here on the ARK. We're going to find temperatures getting a little bit colder, and this is again speculation here, so temperatures getting colder than they have been since the Halloween event with the shorter days. Same length of days would be what I would expect, roughly, and you'll see a lot more coniferous trees, a lot more green, a lot more snow creeping in. The reindeer might expand out beyond their normal reaches. You might find them a little bit more megaloceros wandering about. I'm hoping that they're going to have a few more options, maybe allow you to have a red nose on your megaloceros. It might make it fun. Also, if they add an Ingram for sleigh, I doubt it, but that would be another neat little factor. They'll likely give Santa hats out for completing different tasks. I'm hoping it's going to be a little bit more achievable than the last Thanksgiving event that we had. Killing those turkeys was quite a pain. Also looking for a few more skins, a few more outfits, perhaps hats, you know, Santa hats, elfin hats that you can stick on your dinos. That might be a nice touch. Alright, so apart from that, there's going to be some updates to improve on the usability of the game, making it a little bit better on the slower computers out there. So they're looking to massively improve the game loading speed, streaming times, reducing the hitches by using seek free packages. Any of the things that they can do to improve the gameplay on slower computers would be a big boon. So they've recently released their Xbox version, and so there's a lot of optimizations there, and hopefully there we'll see some of the benefits of those optimizations making it into the computer version as well. So we've also got improved save game, save and load times, rendering and streaming, CPU optimizations from console work, capability for mods to overwrite or add to the ARK Island map, so that's going to be really, really huge for modded app maps. We probably should see some more of the downloadable content and people winning prizes for their content creations for additional map items, but that'll make it a lot of fun to have different options for your ARK maps as you go in there. Might even spice up things for Survival of the Fittest. Alright, so also there's dynamic map mods, stackable, so you can likely take one segment and stack on the next, and hopefully that won't deteriorate some of the optimizations that we're looking to see here in this patch. All current items are now on the master items ID array, so I think that'll make it a little bit easier also for admins and people that are using Sandbox for single player to play a little bit more around with the settings there. And then they mentioned a little bit further out the Procoptodon, the kangaroo, which is a two-seater. Looking forward to that coming out. The naughty or nice, they better get cracking if they're going to get that in before the 25th. But that would also be fun to have the Survival of the Fittest, and then that's where they're also giving away to charity, so that's a pretty cool thing for them and the community to be working on there. Looking at tribe alliances coming up, not in 228, but likely a subsequent patch, either a dot release of 228 or 229 in the coming future. So tribe alliances is going to be awesome, PvE and PvP. So I primarily am on a PvP hardcore server, and it really stinks if you got buddies in other tribes and you happen to fly through and accidentally clip somebody and take them out, not knowing they were even there. You know, you're bulldozing through a forest and you just happen to come across that one person that is also crossing paths. So this will make it so likely we won't have as many problems with that. There's still friendly fire on, so you imagine if you had like a gunfire or weapons of any kind attacking, you'd still hurt them. But dinosaurs, I imagine the friendly fire would be turned off in dinosaurs, much like it is on tribe. Tribe member rankings with customizable per ranking privileges. So right now there's some admin stuff that's pretty neat, but the ability to make it so that tribe members can't open certain doors, say, or access certain things that you have, or perhaps there's certain dinosaurs that you want most tribe members but not all tribe members to ride on, or if you don't want them to speak in global chat if you're trying to keep your communications down. Those kind of things might be neat customizations that they can add in here with the tribal member rankings. And then they got beer brewing. So apart from that, we'll be moving into the year 2016, so we'll take a little closer look at that coming up. But the beer brewing, I imagine that ought to make for interesting character changes. You might have your character slurring speech like you've seen in other games, or might be some staggering, I imagine some blackout effect, much like they have with the torpor. And I imagine it'll also increase your torpor as you drink the beer until you're knocked out, so that might be fun as well. Alright, so looking at January, we've got more creatures, gear, armors, weapons, and structures. If you're curious about the different creatures that they're going to be releasing, you can take some of the other videos that are out there for the dossiers, dino dossiers that have not yet been released. You can learn a little bit more on that. If you subscribe or like, you can get it at additional content I've got here on YouTube that you might be able to see some of the additional creatures that should be coming out in the future, as well as some theory crafting about their uses. The snow swamp and tech caves, the boss arenas, game progression, and boss wars ascension, all of that should be well awaited and well deserved for our player base. That should be a lot of fun to see additional caves and get at a little bit more of the progression in the game, so that it's not just us versus the dinosaurs or us versus tribes. We can actually have some of the bigger, harder content to deal with there. Aquatic and amphibious mating life cycles. I'm not as crazy about that concept. I'm not really wanting to take care of an underwater creature as it gives birth. It's already quite taxing with the mammals on land. I think if there's anything that I do like, it's the egg version, any dinos that drop the eggs. And then they've got some optimizations for DirectX 12 and Windows 10. I myself am not looking to move into Windows 10 until they've had a little bit of a chance to optimize and improve it just on the Windows side. Specific representative on-ground meshes, so that's a nice to have. Right now we've got some things like eggs that have the on-ground meshes, and they're going to be adding additional things here, it looks like. So it'll be nice. I don't mind the boxes so much. It'll definitely make it easier to see and pick up the things that you want, like blackberries, that when you accidentally drop the narcos when you're spilling all the other berries onto the ground, it'll make it easy to pick those blackberries up again, the narco berries, things like that. Random GPU driver crash fix, the True Sky, so that's another good thing. I haven't really encountered that crash personally, but I guess it can be detrimental to some people at some certain aspects of the game. Well, I hope you found this helpful. Please mash that like button if you have. Please subscribe. It's free to do so. Looking forward to the patches coming up, especially the Procoptodon. I think that'll be a lot of fun hopping around with the kangaroo pouch, hopping around inside it. My daughter plays the game with me and occasionally, and that would be a lot of fun for her to steer me around and hop around. Hopefully we'll have some more Christmas items as well releasing. Well, again, thanks for watching. This is Sean Thomas, and I'll catch you next.